that I like to remind myself every day so that I don't get carried away with all that's going on around me. And today, I wanted to share that thing with you. My name is Sylvia Emichetti, and I believe that this one vital thing is what many people in the world tend to forget. It's the fact that you don't have a spirit. You are spirit. And everything else that you have, including your mind and your body, is just a tool for your spirit. So you are essentially a spirit who has a body. And this body is just a vessel for you to use whilst you're on this planet to manifest whatever it is you came here to manifest. When you remember this always, you'll know how to use your tools efficiently. Because, like it or not, it is your responsibility to make sure that your tools are in absolute working condition. Otherwise, guess what? You will deliberately decide on your own. Yes, you will make that decision to check out of that body. It does sound incredible, doesn't it? I'm sure you're there saying, oh no, Sylvia, that's not even possible. Why in the world would I want to deliberately check out of my own body? But guess what? It's true. If your body is no longer fit for purpose, then your spirit will be forced to exit it. That is the law. When you think about the word suicide, what comes to mind for many people is that person who's had it. You know, they've got lots of problems and they wake up one morning and decide to end it. But that's not the only suicide there is. There are many suicidal people walking around unconsciously doing things to their body that will cause for their spirit to exit the building faster than they can imagine. And yes, they have no idea. They have no clue that they're actually gradually becoming suicidal. Not until most of them have passed away do they then realize that, oh wow, it's their activities and how they treated their vessel that has allowed them to check out early. And so the question is, how are you treating your vessel? Are you pushing it to an early checkout? There's that general fear that people have of checking out of this planet, let alone checking out early. Those are the ones that they say gone too soon. So are you planning to go soon? Because I was wondering, if most people are already afraid to die and most people frown at the idea of suicide, shouldn't that make us all very conscious of taking good care of our bodies so that we don't check out of it prematurely? Think of yourself as the proud owner of a brand new, very expensive Ferrari. How would you treat it? What kind of petrol would you put in it? Are you going to fuel it with a dodgy petrol, or will you buy premium gas for it? Will you service it regularly with very good quality oil? Or will you go for the cheap oil that would likely knock your engine? Remember, you are not the Ferrari. You are the proud owner of the Ferrari, the one who should enjoy driving it around and getting satisfaction from using it. Are you getting satisfaction from using your body right now? If you're up in the morning and your body's too weak to start its engine, how do you think that your spirit will feel that day? Will you hang on to something that's not working for you? No. You'll eventually abandon it and end up checking out of it. If that expensive Ferrari has been used recklessly and it's now damaged and it won't take you from point A to B, then it's useless. It's no longer roadworthy. It's considered a scrap, as we like to call it, like a banger. It's a banger. And that means you can no longer carry on with your journey on this earth. So the question is, do you have a Ferrari that's in good working condition? And how long do you reckon it will last based on how you're treating it? Is it happy to serve you? What are you doing to keep it serviced? Is your spirit happy to wake up and work with it every single day? Or are you gradually committing suicide with it without even knowing? Are you reducing its lifespan, taking that expensive vessel that you've been blessed with and driving it off a cliff? I think you'll agree with me that there are plenty suicidals walking on the streets than we originally thought. The beauty of it is that just like that car that has a warning light that will come on to indicate that the fuel level is low or that the water coolant is low, so is your vessel. It's always giving you the signs to treat it better, to love it and to get to know it well. Otherwise, it will not work for you. Whether it be by eating the right foods, getting enough rest, thinking the right thoughts, working with nature to bring balance to your mind, your body, and your soul. You, the spirit, have to keep your vessel healthy. Many are heading to that point where the spirit will say, hasta la vista, ciao, arrivederci, bye-bye. I've ruined it, so I'm out. Because the universe will take it away from you because it lacks the balance that's needed for your spirit to flourish in that body. We have misused and abused our tool. It's bound to become suicidal. Think of yourself as the factory owner, the big boss. You own this factory with all these tools working for you. How is it that some people still think they are the tools? No. You are the owner of the factory. Your body, your mind, your intellect, your intuition, they all work for you. They're all here to serve you whilst you evolve on this earth. And the more you know how to make better use of them, the more enjoyable your experience will be. But many of us can't even see ourselves as the big boss who's managing all these tools. First of all, they look at their body and they think, I am this body that is soon going to die. If I can just live long, I'll be fine. So they become even more afraid of dying. No, it's not enough. You must live well to have made full use of that experience and that opportunity that you've been given. You are not here to just live. You are here to live well and experience. Your spirit will stay as long as it needs to. If it's happy, you should be happy to enjoy the beauty that this world has got to offer, to add to your spiritual experience and your evolution, to be rich with experiences so that you can take something that's worthy back with you. You're not here to drag your tool around like it's a curse, like it's a headache that we all keep complaining about. Ah, my body hurts. I'm suffering from stress, anxiety, depression, mental illness. Ah, in Nigeria we say, haba, kilo de, what is it? We're here to be happy, to make our tools happy, to flourish, to journey back home, rich in spiritual experience. So we have to ask ourselves, as the spirit, as the factory owner, as the big boss, what am I doing wrong with my tools? Am I making myself suicidal? And the answer lies with each person and the activities that they're putting their body through. So it's about time we start taking better care of our tools so that we don't end up checking out of it too early. Think about these words as you go about your daily lives. Natural. Balance, moderation, self-control, self-respect. You must love and respect yourself to treat your tools better. And finally, the one thing that has really helped me a lot is always reminding myself every day, you don't have a spirit, you are spirit. What you have is several cloaks, and this body is just one of them. And it's up to you if you want your cloak to be that smooth driving Ferrari or if you want it to be a scrap. For me, I think too highly of myself, so I dare not make my vessel a scrap. And I hope you think highly of yourself as well. Bye for now.